whinging, will you? I'm telling you, it'll be all right.
Oh, it's all right for you. You weren't there. Parker's in the governor's office right now. We'll have a guess at who she's stopping in.
Who's the mongrel who went through me locker?
What are you talking about?
Oh, bloody Peter thief, that's what. All of me buy-up's gone. Now, who done it?
Oh, gosh, I'm glad you said that, Ruth. Look, I didn't say anything because I thought, well, somebody may have borrowed it.
What are you talking about?
My talcum powder. I had a lovely tin. It was purple with silver on it, and it's gone. You haven't seen it, have you?
What do you mean by that? Do you reckon I took it or something?
No, of course not. I just thought that maybe...
Well, don't. You want to watch it, Mason? You could ruin reputation saying things like that.
Yeah, what's going on?
Oh, nothing, Mrs. Morris. Girls' tour. Isn't that right, Mason?
Yes, that's right. Mrs. Morris, are they all right?
I suppose that's it then. I'll just have to wait.
Don't be stupid, Cass. A screw might come in. Look, it wasn't me. They made me do it. I didn't do nothing. Cass. They made me do it, honest.
Cass, I have to talk to you. It's very urgent.
I don't believe you, Phyllis. And we're going to talk about this sometime, right?
Sit down. They made me do it, honest.
Well, you were a lot of help.
Are you still standing, aren't you?
Back to normal, are we?
No way. We're doing our own gear and that's all.
Yeah, this place stinks enough without pondering up anymore.
That's enough, Hunt. You can go just as slow and solitary, you know.
Oh, Mrs. Powell, have you heard how Myra is?
She's regained consciousness, that's all I know.
Ah, terrific.
Good one, Rev. Yes, Struth. I thought she was really going to blow his stack then.
Oh, what the do, Miss Ferguson?
You'll find out.
Put your mag on this time, Dunbar.
Oh, you can go too. She wants to see you also, Hunt.
We've got a right to know what we're doing here.
Shut up, Hunt. You'll find out soon enough.
Didn't even finish me brekkie.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson. Now, ladies, I'd like to introduce you to Dr. Jonathan Edmonds. Doctor, this is Phyllis Hunt.
Hello, Phyllis.
G'day.
And Cass Parker.
Morning, Cass.
Dr. Edmonds has been appointed to conduct some studies here, and you two have been selected to take part.
Is he a shrink?
Watch your mouth, Hunt.
That's all right, Miss Ferguson.
I don't know, Mrs. Reynolds. I don't know anyone else messing around inside me head.
Cass, I think you'd better hear why Dr. Edmonds has selected you before you say a definite no.
Well, I don't like the sound of it so far, Mrs. Reynolds.
Mrs. Reynolds, could I have a word with these women alone?
Yes, of course. I'll be in the staff room if you need me. Miss Ferguson will wait outside.
Well, this is a bit cosier. Now, Cass, why don't you tell me what you're worried about? Will you give me a chance?
You sure that's all there is to it? And you reckon you could help?
Yeah.
What? Don't sound too bad.
Phyllis?
What's in it for me?
Oh, nice cup of tea. And any cigarettes you might find lying around on the desk.
Yeah, all right.
Good.
Oh, not bad. We talk and he listens, and according to him, we walk out of here. Solid citizens.
What do you got to talk about to work that magic?
Well, just ourselves. Name's Dr. Jonathan Edmonds. He seems all right.
The toss-up between spending time with you or him.
There must be some things you liked about your childhood.
Yeah, no one stuck their nose into me business.
You mean your parents didn't care what you did?
What a laugh. They're always blind drunk.
So who looked after you and your brothers?
We looked after ourselves. Well, me and Mick did. Mick was the eldest. I used to look out for little Timmy.
Do you still see them?
Oh, yeah. Mick used to come. He's in Darwin now.
What about Timmy?
Oh, Timmy's... Look, what's it to you anyway?
I'd like to help you. I need to know why you're here.
Well, why don't you look at me bloody file? It's all there. Assault, thieving, drugs. Since when do they need a reason for locking you up?
I know what your convictions are, Phyllis. I'd like to know why you got into trouble in the first place. You seem to. You seem to have something against the establishment.
If you think I hate the morons that put me in here, you're right. They even made me give up my little girl. She's adopted now. Look, why don't you just stick it and mind your own bloody business?
As you wish.
Hey, Phyllis!
Hey, you go with the doc. Hey, it's a pushover. I sit there talking and smoking and he listens.
Oh, is that all?
What'd you expect, brain surgery?
Oh, did you find out if he's married?
Who cares? He's a con, they all are.
Here, you going back?
Yeah, why not?
Is
sounds like a blunt.
Oh, hello, Phyllis. How was Dr. Edmonds this morning?
Well, he was okay. We had a really nice talk.
Oh, that's good. I wish I could go and see him. Maybe he could help me sort out my marital problem. Well, how could you say that? I've just said no to a marriage proposal and there's nobody else around who might even ask. Oh, Daphne.
Oh, here, I'll do it for you, Pixie.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Phyllis. That was very nice.
It's okay.
Geez, now I've seen everything.
Oh, thank you.
Did you see that?
Mm.
Nothing to worry about, though. It's a definite improvement.
Well, you might be right.
Can you do up my shoelace? It's come undone.
I'll get stuff, will you?
Well, how come you're sucking up to Pixie then?
She just needs a hand, that's all.
Yeah. Pity there aren't more people around here with a few manners.
Thanks, Cass. It's typical of this bloody pack of morons to pick on you just because you're trying to help someone.
What the hell do you want?
We just came in to see if the two-up game was still on.
Yeah? Well, where the hell is it?
Where the hell's what? I don't know what you're talking about.
My stash. Somebody's pinched it again.
What's the big red bonus?
No, it was a misery bonus. You're a liar, Hunt.
Look, I'm on your side, remember?
I want to know who it is. This time, I'll bloody kill her.
Just lay off, will you, and I'll help you find out. I reckon it might be Bobby.
I don't trust any of these bitches.
Yeah, well, I'll sit around for you if you like and see what I can find out.
Hey, you do that.
But if I find out it was you,